Most boats use gasoline, and these days, nearly all the gasoline sold in the U.S. contains ethanol. Ethanol and boat engines haven't always played well together. Hi, I'm Scott Croft with Boat Owners Association of the United States, here to share some ethanol do's and don'ts to keep your boat motor running smoothly, saving you from costly repair bills. Now more than ever, boaters need to be aware of what's going into their tank. While most of today's recreational boat engines are designed to burn E10, some gas stations now sell E15, and a few even carry E85. Putting gasoline with more than 10% ethanol in your boat's tank not only breaks the law, but will likely damage your engine and void the warranty. For this reason, be cautious when putting gas in your trailerable boat at the gas station. Many boaters fill the tow vehicle first, then simply fill the boat with the same dispensing nozzle. Keep an eye out for this little orange sticker warning about using E15, and always double check pump labels and fuel selection before filling the boat. Boaters also need to be careful when storing E10 in boats for long periods because it can phase separate. Most often condensation from humid air entering through the tank's vent combines with ethanol and creates a corrosive mixture at the bottom of the tank. No stabilizer can return phase separated fuel to its pristine state. You have to drain the tank, a job best left to a pro. Keeping a built-in fuel tank nearly full over the winter decreases the amount of condensation and risk of phase separation. And never plug up a fuel system vent. Doing so creates an explosion hazard. You can always know that fueling at the fuel dock is a safe way to ensure you're putting the right kind of gas in your boat's engine. But for those who do so at gas stations, know that ethanol is here to stay, so be aware on how to use it. If you'd like to know more about using ethanol in boat engines, go to BoatUS.com/ethanol.